Hello. Welcome back to the YouTube, guys. Cream of rice is in. So welcome back to the YouTube. What have I been up to? Well, I've been ill again. It turns out the virus was not out of my system. And, I think it was the vid. I got the vid. And, I had to have a week off last week because I was fucked. The fatigue was killing me. So I could barely function. I wasn't really motivated to train, which tells me there's an issue. So I can't really take this serious. Just jiggle it around my chin. Okay, cool. Yeah, so your readiness to train should be a good indicator of where you're at in regards to fatigue. So if you're noticing and you're not ill, you don't have to be ill, but you notice you've had weeks of hard training and you're really unmotivated to train, and things like sleep is affected, you're irritable, your appetite's gone down, maybe digestion's been affected, then potentially you've built up too much systemic fatigue and you need to pull back with training. And these were some of the things that I was noticing with myself, being ill. So part of me is like, don't be a bitch, train. And the other part of me is like, what would you say to a client? And it'd be rest until you're ready. And it was not just me, I've noticed pretty much all of my fucking clients have been ill. There's some shit going around in the gym. So I've just noticed a similar trend with other people, which is useful because I've been able to advise them on how to negate this issue and not train through it, basically. Because sometimes the most productive thing you can do is pulling back. And part of being a great athlete is being balance. It's not about going all in one direction. It's about knowing when to pull back and when to hold. And that is the great thing about bodybuilding, is balance. In other news, I got a fucking TV. Yeah, and during my week off, Spider-Man 2 came out. I love gaming. I'm a fucking nerd at heart. And I love the Spider-Man games as well. So that came out. I was playing on my other TV. I was like, do you know what? Treat yourself. So I was like, I'm not playing anymore on this motherfucking TV. I'm going to get another one. I know it's small, but I'm not a guy who treats himself much, because since coaching and since bodybuilding, they've been my priority to grow those two things, and that's where my life's been sort of focused on. So to have time off and just chill out and treat myself to different things, it's been cool. And that is balance. That's balance. It all comes down to balance. So the plan of action today, guys, what we're gonna be fucking doing is we're gonna be training a bit of legs, right? Because that's really the only good bit I can train. The first session back since being a little bit ill. We'll see how it goes, but we'll train legs with the lads. Mitch behind the camera, and also Hayden. So it should be a sick session. And my microwave's telling me to eat some cream of rice, so I'm gonna get that down me, and I'll meet you guys in the gym. Starting on carbs today. So I think starting on carbs at the start of the session is cool because obviously you're nice and fresh. So usually when you train carbs at the end, you sort of, a lot of people half-arse it. And even if you don't want to half-arse it, you still won't have the same oomph as you were at the beginning of the session. And I've noticed what I'm going to do on calves, this way of training them has massively grown my calves. They're now 18 inches, which is a fun little trivia for you guys. But also, I noticed it helps in regards to getting depth in things like squats, because you'll have an increased ankle flexion, which is good. Obviously, it helps part and parcel. So, calves at the beginning of the session, guys. You don't want to be a skinny bitch. Hey, waiting on Hayden at the moment. He is in the gym. He waited for us to get here to then go and train shoulders. He had to do get a couple of sets in side raises before he starts legs. I'm not joking though. Like he was moaning that we were late. Waiting for us to get here and fucked off and did side raises. So we're just doing calves. He'll be joining us soon. So don't you worry, sit tightly and he'll be here with us shortly. Okay, let's go. Feel like I'm gonna need to warm up a lot today, just because it feels stiff. You know, just having a little bit of time off the gym, and just, you know, that virus sort of stiffness that you get in the joints. Yeah, I feel like a brittle old soul. Obviously, when you're doing calves, you gotta approach it like you train any other fucking muscle. Train your calves like you would train a squat, because you want to have that type of intensity there. Because if you train them like a pussy hole, you have calves like a pussy hole. And cue Hayden Woodcock.
Hello, welcome to ITV News. Today on ITV News.
The weather.
Top.
Yes!
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 Oh, yes!
Oh, look at this gentleman!
Oh,
indubitably!
This gentleman!
Oh, mysterious! Mysterio!
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 Come on, then. One more.
Tasty.
It's one more.
No.
I'm not mine.
Mitch is already hot. Mitch is training cars for the first time ever. Jack's peeking at me sexily. Hey Jack.
Okay.
Oh yes.
Let's go. That's it, keep the hips in place. That's it, again. Up, up, up. Lovely. That's it.
I feel like I'm recording a music video. Are you ready? Easy, mom. Just light. Yep.
Good.
Very tasty, mate. Come on. Good. Yep. Hold on.
Fuck me.
How's that?
Well, it's definitely PB.
Yeah? How do your Achilles feel?
Shit, fucking. I thought that shit, man.
Come on.
I felt heavy on the calves.
Did it feel heavier than last week?
A little bit. A little bit. Cool. Not bad for a COVID patient.
It's okay.
You're not going to throw that against the wall?
What?
You're not going to throw that against the wall?
I'm not throwing against the wall.
Go on. See, you tricked me there.
You got that?
I thought you were going to throw me around.
That was throwing you around.
And you just went straight in. Let's go, baby. Anakin, come on.
Anakin! Oh. Anakin! Up, up, up!
Anakin!
Anakin!
Up, up, up!
Drive!
I didn't think you shouted Anakin at me then.
I was.
Anakin!
Two sets on that. One straight set. Last set is a drop set. So you go to failure, then you drop halfway, half the weight. Continue. And the next exercise from the standing calf is going to be the seated calf. And it'll be just two straight sets on that.
Like I said, this shit that I'm doing here, we'll do about 2-3 times a week.
And it has massively helped me grow my calves. It's also helped with clients as well, because obviously if something works very fucking well, I'll share it with my clients, let them in on the secret. But
let's go!
Lovely. Nice, bro. Come on. Come on. Yep. Good. Yep. Come on now. Yes. 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 That was lovely jubbly. Alrighty then. Nice.
You two pieces. This is my last resort.
Lovely, mate. Oh no.
Ooh.
Yep.
Ooh, yes.
Yep.
Oh, good. Ooh.
Oh. Oh. This weight, I expected about 4 reps. I've got 8, so we doubled, and then big dick moves now. So, yeah, what can I say?
A lot of people will fuck up the hamstring curl and they'll just swing it. You'll notice with that set I kept my hips in place, so the tension is on the hamstring curl. And you'll notice, I mean I've made these mistakes in the past personally, you know, where you just swing it, you just move weight from A to B. And I find it particularly on this movement, like I say, like a hamstring curl. And obviously the reason why I'm trying to give this advice is to sort of fast track that trial and error process and find it out for yourself, because again, I've made these mistakes, so I've gone, actually I'll do it this way because this is the productive way to do things, the most conducive for my progress. And with this in particular, it's very much worth keeping yourself nice and strict and make sure you're actually feeling it on the isolation. You know, when you're doing isolation movements, having a decent connection is very much worth it, because you are isolating that muscle. So it's worth dropping the weight back, opting for higher rep ranges, making sure that you can connect with it, and once you're efficient with that skill, with that movement, and you can continuously feel it without, you know, consciously thinking about the cues, then start escalating the weight. There's a certain priority of doing things. So focus on your execution initially, be efficient and connect well with that particular movement. And this applies for different movements as well, and then progress the weight. Session, I'm like, ugh. But nevertheless, we're not gonna fucking bitch out. And we'll see how the set goes, you know? Sometimes you can placebo yourself negatively, so gotta keep optimistic and just fucking rinse this set. It'll be great. The performance will dictate how I actually am. And if the performance is taking a very steep decline, we'll just act accordingly. But if it's going very well, then we go through. But we're gonna go in now. Yo, bro. Okay. I smell marijuana.
Hold up.
Yes! Cover!
Yes! Up! Ah! Oh. Oh.
Good sort of set. Yeah, as I said before, it's my mindset. So I just wanted to fuck it absolute red hot. And then I just kept going and going and going. And when you're in a set, you try to get everything out of it. The mindset is not thinking, can't wait for this set to end, or I've only got this many reps. You try to stay in that set for as long as fucking possible. You know, after another hard rep, challenge yourself, get out another one, fucking demand it from yourself. You'd be surprised how much you can fucking get. You know, go fucking day. Hayden's had to one up me with half a plate aside, you know. Come on, big boy. That's it, man. Slowly, clean. Yep. There we go. Nice. And again, stumble. Oh! Lovely. Good! Yes, stumble! Up, 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 up! And again. Yeah, still you, still you, still easy. Come on, fucking bitch out. Draw! All the way! Let's go. Ah! One fucking more! Everything. How much you fucking want this? Ah! Yes!
Yes.
Compose! That's it.
Easy. That's it.
Very fucking easy. Lovely.
Oh!
And again. Up, 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 up.
Oh!
That's it. Big brace. Drive! Ah! That's it. Still easy. Up, 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 up. There we fucking go. Come on now. Come on. Up! Up! Yes! Let's go. Drive! Drive! Oh, yes! Again! Again! Come on! Up! 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 One fucking more! Come on! Show me how much you fucking want this. Let's have it! Nice! Yes! Again! 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 Come on! Come on! How with you? No second places. Drive! All the way! Yes, yes. So I'm feeling fucked. I felt fucked before that set. That set. Ooh. It went very well. It went better than I thought it was going to, and then obviously I just put myself in a place where, you know, I had a great set. But following that, the list for my body, like I say, it's the initial session back, so I don't want to put myself in a hole where I'm having to take a few days off again, so here's the happy medium. I've done a set like that, so I'm going to take a set away from a compound, because usually I would do an additional set on a compound. I'll go straight out to the isolations to finish up with. But I'm still gonna fucking have a crazy set on this. Again, giving everything to everything whilst I'm here. That's what it's about. Also, it's about just not being a dick at the same time, making myself ill. Thank you.
chest. Catch your breath. Not for too long. Boom. 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 Okay, cool. Same shit again. We're gonna drop the weight. Really fucking rinse out the quads. This is not as fatiguing as a compound, but we're still able to apply a good amount of stimulus to the quads. Hence the happy medium. Balance. Boom. 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 Again. Boom. Okay. Pulses now. Boom. 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 See here, fuck all weight on there, and got to a point where I failed on it, failed on the partials, and then we finished off with just the eccentrics. We failed on that, so quads just were absolutely fucked up then. So for me, that is the session, so I don't run into the ground. We've got Hayden finishing off, and we've also got cameraman Mitch finishing off as well. Obviously, you know, I hope one day I'm able to make a YouTube video and I will be of health to do so. I'll be able to have like a proper fucking session. Despite that, I feel like I've had a decent session anyway. You know, it was a good time. You know, I'm happy with how things went considering how I was feeling. I still think it was nice and productive. So, until next time, folks.